Oh, excuse me. Excuse me.
Who, me?
Yes, waiter. I'm almost ready to order.
Oh, well.
But I just have one question. Have you tried the steak and the fries? How do they taste?
I heard that.
What? Huh?
I heard a super sentence. Who said, have you tried the steak and the fries?
I did. That's a super sentence?
Yes, it is. It goes like this. Have you something, the something, and the something else?
Oh.
That's not my favorite super sentence either. But can you use it in another way?
Well, actually, yes. I have another question for the server. Have you tried the fish and the soup?
Have you tried the fish and the soup?
No, I haven't.
Have you eaten the pasta and the bread?
No.
Have you eaten the pasta and the bread?
No, no, no.
Interesting. Have you tried the pork and the corn?
No.
The beans and the rice?
No.
The ice cream and the臭豆腐?
No, no, no.
You mean to say that you haven't tried any of this food?
That's right. But have you tried the fork and the spoon?
The fork and the spoon?
The fork and the spoon. That's the name of my restaurant. It's right over there.
You mean the one with lots and lots of customers?
Yes, and the big sign that says, the fork and the spoon. Well, I have to go now. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Wow, it looks delicious. Have you been to the fork and the spoon?
I have not. We should go.
We should go, yes.
But first, say this with me.
Oh, yes.
A super sentence every day will make your English great. All right, let's go.
You're paying.
Okay.